Today, I want to talk about this repository that I have called MISC Python Apps. It's basically a collection of Python scripts or applications that I've written to try and understand Python and work with Python more. Typically, if I'm working with web frameworks, it's like React or PHP or JavaScript. And I don't do too much with Python, but I do enjoy building small applications to help get things done, productivity tools, or just looking up quick things like using a weather API to look up the amount of rain for the week, which helps me as a vegetable gardener, or generating a password using a script that I know that I wrote myself, that password is being randomized and not relying on an application to do it for me. So I've shared a video about this before and kind of the advantages of using a programming language that you don't typically use every day as a way to strengthen your knowledge as a programmer. Like I said, I made a video on this before, which I'll link below if you want to find out which each of these individual applications does. But today I wanted to show how someone can get started using this and the interface that I built in the main directory of the project, which will allow you to select whatever application you want to run using a package called Prompt Toolkit. Okay, so here I am in a terminal application. I'm on Windows, and Windows actually created a really good terminal application. I would encourage you to check that out. It's on the Microsoft Store. The requirements for this are just that you have Python installed, that you have a terminal application, and that you have pip. So I use pip to install packages, very common package manager for Python. So I'm in my GitHub directory in my terminal, and I'm gonna just copy the first command in the README, which will clone the repository. From here, I'll change directories into the cloned repository, and I'm going to install the requirements in the requirements.txt file. This is just for the prompt toolkit, which will be the like the main menu or the app selector for this repository. From here, we can simply type python main.py, and you'll see the directory shows up in a window using the prompt toolkit. So I can just use the arrow keys to select which one I want. Let's say I want the password generator. Hit enter to select it. Press tab to go down to the OK or cancel. If I cancel, it closes the program. If I run it again, I can select a different option here. Let's do the password generator. It's a pretty simple one. And the terminal opens back up with how many characters you want the password to be. I'll say 60, and this is my randomized password. So I think in the future, maybe I will adjust this to stay in this UI when it's running the application rather than switching back and forth in the terminal. But I thought this was worth sharing. It is cool to make a GUI in Python for the application, and I can show you what that looks like. We can kind of walk through it here. So again, I'm using the prompt toolkit. I'm assigning the directories using pathlib for the paths. And that way I'm not statically putting in each directory name. I'm just generating the directories using Python, which is obviously the thing to do. Then I'm accounting for each of the directories having a main.py file. So within each folder here, you'll see they all have a main.py file. And that's the main Python file for the application. So this first block is just saying, get all of the directories within the project. And this is saying, look for the main.py file within each project. And if there is none, display that there's no main.py. And here I'm making a radio list dialog box using the prompt toolkit and asking the user for the selection. I really am enjoying building these Python applications. It is really fun. And I feel like I've come up with some useful apps that will benefit me in making me more productive and making things easier for me to generate things like a README file or convert CSV to JSON easily. And I can do that now with this cool menu. And yeah, check it out and start the repository if you're interested on GitHub. Let me know down below in the comments if you have any ideas for a small application that I can include within this list. And I hope this inspires you to look into Python and make your own scripts or applications. Thank you so much for watching, and I'll catch you in the next video.